In the previous video in our cloud management series, we covered provisioning setup options. This video covers troubleshooting and operations for cloud management on the ServiceNow platform. Link time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. Here's the Cloud Root Cause Analysis Dashboard, which contains reports that can help you troubleshoot issues with cloud management. The first tab of the dashboard opens to display reports, in the form of charts, that summarize the cloud orchestration trail, with relevant trail records listed under the reports. We can choose any combination of filters on the left to filter the data, and the charts update accordingly. And we can reset the filters. The charts group records by different attributes. The Trails chart groups orchestration trails data by the template on which a cloud management action was applied. Stages groups data by stage, which identifies when the transaction took place. Components groups data by the component in the system involved in the transaction. Steps groups data by the descriptive step associated with the stage and component. To ensure that we're seeing the latest data, we can refresh the entire dashboard or each chart individually. Let's look at an example of using root cause analysis to determine the cause of a failed request in the cloud user portal. We locate the failed request and copy the request item number. Now we return to the Cloud Root Cause Analysis dashboard and enter this value into the Request Item menu. The Cloud Orchestration Trails Detail list refreshes and displays only trails for that request item, so we can analyze the output and see exactly where the problem started. For this item, it looks like there's a problem with our AWS Cloud Formation template. Let's look at a cloud orchestration trail, comprised of activity logs for all cloud resource activity on an instance. In our example, we want to track down an AWS access error that occurred on a specific date. This trail entry looks promising. It displays the level of output and the template on which the cloud management action was applied. If applicable, we may also see the target instance, the user, and the user group. Here's the message and the message details, which confirm that AWS couldn't validate the provided access credentials. Looks like we might have entered the password incorrectly here. In our example, we've configured the form to display the step field, which identifies additional information about the transaction, including the component and the stage. Because all cloud activity goes through the mid-server, a corresponding entry on the mid-server is captured in the Cloud API trail. Let's look in the Cloud API library to see its components. Back in the Cloud API trail, let's look for an error entry occurring on the same date as the AWS access error we found in the cloud orchestration trail. And here it is. We can see the mid-server through which the discovery was performed, the root status, either success, error, or executing, and the input parameters, if there were any. We also see the interface that the API used, and that the action was invoked by the CMP, or Cloud Management Platform, the method the API used, and the cloud provider. If there's more information about this trail entry, it'll appear in the Cloud API Trail Logs list. In this entry, we can review the values for several log keys recorded here. Now let's look at the Cloud API dashboard, which displays reports about the Cloud API trail. Here we can see the Cloud APIs that have been executed, broken down by provider, execution status, and connector. and this widget displays the number of API calls in the queue. Notice the real-time icon. This indicates that updates are being made in real time on this widget. We can also see how our API methods are executing, broken out by the number of successes and errors. And here's the number of API invocations for today, broken out by interface. We can click on a block to access the list of Cloud API trails. Now let's switch gears to look at Cloud Operations. The Cloud Operations dashboard breaks down cloud service requests from your end users, broken down by requester, and the cloud stacks that you offer in the Cloud User Portal, broken down by data center. The data is grouped by owner group by default. We can see the data grouped by another attribute by selecting a different option in the Group By menu. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.